Now we're going to take a look at solving factorable quadratic equations graphically. And we'll also show how we can use the graph of a quadratic to help us factor quadratics. So if we want to solve x squared plus 4x equals 0 graphically, we'll graph the function y equals x squared plus 4x on the calculator. Before we do this, remember, graphically, if you replace y with 0 and solve for x, this is the procedure for determining the x-intercepts. So the x-coordinates of the x-intercepts are going to represent the solutions to the given equation. So we'll go ahead and press y equals, and now we'll type in our function, y equals x squared plus 4x. And then we'll press zoom 6 to make sure we have the standard window. So it's pretty easy to see on this graph that we have an x-intercept of negative 4 comma 0 and another x-intercept here at the origin at the point 0 comma 0. Let's go ahead and verify this with the calculator. If we press second trace option 2 for 0, the calculator will find the x-intercepts for us. So if we press option 2, now it's going to ask us for the left bound. So if we want to verify this x-intercept here, to the left of this point would be just below the x-intercept, maybe somewhere in here. Press enter, and if we want to move to the right of the x-intercept here, we'd actually be above that point, maybe somewhere in here. Press enter, enter one more time. This verifies this x-intercept is the point 0, 0, and now we'll also verify this x-intercept here. So again, we'll press second, trace, option 2, and now to the left of this x-intercept, this would mean we want to be just above this x-intercept. So we'll press the left arrow until we're just above this x-intercept. Press enter. To the right, in this case, means just below, maybe somewhere in here. Enter, and then enter one more time. So this verifies our other x-intercept is the point negative 4, comma 0. So the x-intercepts were the points 0, 0, and the point negative 4, 0. So again, this is telling us that when x is 0, y is also 0, and when x is negative 4, y is equal to 0. Therefore, our solutions are x equals 0, this x-coordinate here, or x equals negative 4, this x-coordinate here. And notice how once we have the x-intercepts, we can actually work backwards and factor the original quadratic equation. Meaning if x equals 0 is a solution, then x would have to be a factor of the given equation. And if x equals negative 4 is a solution, then one of the factors of the original equation would have had to been x plus 4, which is how we would factor the original quadratic equation. Let's take a look at another example. Again, if we want to solve this equation graphically, we want to graph the function y equals x squared plus 4x minus 12. And if we replace y with 0 and solve for x, we know this is the procedure for finding the x-intercepts. So we'll graph the blue function and identify the x-intercepts, and the x-coordinates of those intercepts will be our solutions. So we'll press y equals, clear out the old function, and type in the new function. We have x squared plus 4x minus 12. Press graph, and we can see our x-intercepts look like they are negative 6 and positive 2. But again, we'll go ahead and verify this by pressing second trace option 2. And let's find this x-intercept here first. So to the left of this x-intercept would be below. Press enter. To the right would be above. Press enter. And then enter again. So this verifies this x-intercept is the point 2, 0. And now we'll verify the one on the left as well. So second trace option 2. We have to swing way over to the left. If you hold this down, it will continue moving. Now to the left of this x-intercept would be above, somewhere in here. Press enter. Right bound would be below. Enter. Then enter one more time. And this verifies this x-intercept as well. So again, the x-intercepts were the points negative 6, 0, and 2, 0. So when x is negative 6, y is 0. And when x is 2, y is 0. Therefore, our solutions are x equals negative 6 or x equals positive 2. And again, if we wanted to, we can use this information to factor the original equation. If x equals negative 6 is a solution, one of the factors would have been x plus 6. And if x equals 2 is a solution, one of the factors would have been x minus 2. So it is possible to use the graphs of quadratics to not only solve quadratic equations, but also to help us factor if needed. I hope this was helpful.